finally to our NewsHour Shares, something that caught our eye that may be of interest to you as well. The Smithsonian Institution's collection is 150 million objects strong. But when the time comes to take those priceless pieces on the road, how do they keep them safe? The NewsHour's Julia Griffin got a behind-the-scenes look at their latest tour.
Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
July 16th, 1969. Launch of the historic Apollo 11 mission that captivated a nation. Now, nearly five decades later, the command module that bore Neil Armstrong, Michael Collins, and Buzz Aldrin to the moon and back is on its latest adventure, a two-year, four-stop tour across America.
Being in the presence of the real artifact, there's nothing like it.
Catherine Halpern is the project director overseeing the Destination Moon traveling exhibition.
To share the original object with the public, for them to see it in their hometown or to at least be able to travel an hour or two as opposed to having to come all the way to Washington, I think it's going to be incredibly inspiring for all sorts of different people.
National Air and Space Museum object conservator Lisa Young gave us an up-close look at the Columbia module before it left the nation's capital.
Do you think this could do the trip again in this state?
Probably not.
Young's team prepared not just the spacecraft, but a treasure trove of mission-flown objects, including the crew's medical kit, Aldrin's visor, and Collins's watch.
These are sensitive fabrics, they're mylars, Velcro, things that we have today and we use every day, but in the 1960s, that was not common. So we need to look at how they're degrading, stabilize them for the tour.
But taking Apollo 11 artifacts on the road isn't as simple as moving your family across country.
Think of coordinating a ballet. That's really what's involved here. Every step, every move is choreographed to make sure that the objects are safe and that the people working around them are safe as well.
If it's a complicated object, it has layers of packing.
Vicky Possoff, the tour's registrar, outlined the steps Smithsonian took to protect the Apollo 11 objects in transit.
In each box, there are internal fittings that are custom cut and shaped for that object.
Special linings keep unwanted vapors out. Silica gel packets help maintain optimal humidity levels. And custom cushioned feet shield objects from vibrations during transport. But moving the command module itself presents its own mammoth challenge.
It's an awkward, heavy object with fragile surfaces, so we can't wrap it like a traditional museum object.
Its upgraded stand can be lifted and repositioned without ever touching the spacecraft, and a special raincoat shields the module during outdoor transits.
Anything at that point could happen. You could have a bird fly by, you could have pollen in the air, all of those things that can get on the surfaces from our environment outside.
FedEx has partnered with Smithsonian to move the exhibition from one place to another. It's the last part of a big plan to keep the objects safe.
Making sure that these objects are around for future generations is really the most important part of our job. We want this to be another 50 years worth of time that they get to spend in the public eye.
Destination Moon, the Apollo 11 mission, is now on display at Texas's Space Center Houston. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Julia Griffin in Chantilly, Virginia.
Online, we examine more artifacts in the exhibit, including Buzz Aldrin's helmet. That and more is on our website, pbs.org/newshour.